Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am Ezekiel Bruni, the web designer with a voice for radio and a face that is also pretty great for radio. Now, let's see. We're here to talk about Tailor Brands on behalf of Website Planet. Tailor Brands is a do-it-yourself logo generator online service, and let's get right into it. We're here on the homepage now. It's familiar to me. I'm already logged in because I have used Tailor Brands before, mostly to review it for other articles. I haven't actually used any logos I've generated. That's not to say they're bad. I just prefer to do things from scratch myself. But here we are at Tailor Brands, and we are making a logo for Website Planet. This is the current logo. Now, I don't think that the logo we're going to make today will actually be the final logo chosen, because I'm actually reviewing 14 logo services in total, both do-it-yourself and do-it-for-me style logo services. But here we are. You type in the name of the business you want to make a logo for, and let's type in an industry. Let's go with web design. There we go, web design. And you can type in a small description of what you do. I don't think it actually matters much to the algorithm unless they're analyzing keywords in the description. So, whatever the case, I'm going to skip this little part. Now, what kind of logo do we want? Do we want just the name with typography? Do we want something initial-based? Or something icon-based? This is what we're working with now. And while I do like the idea of an initial-based logo, they kind of expect an icon, I believe. So we're going to go with an icon-based logo. Now, there are lots of website and wireframe-themed icons based on this keyword here, web design. But none of them feel quite right. They're all a bit generic, which is to be expected. Let's try something a little different. Oh, I'd like to check. A different logo service actually had a little bit of a problem with keywords. Oh no, this one doesn't. Never mind. I'll address that in a different review. Okay, so web design didn't work out for us. Let's try Planet. Now here we have a lot of planet-based logos, which are fantastic. And as you can see, there are tons of them. The library of logos is downright huge. Huge. I was actually going to look up some copyright-free music to hum during parts like this, but I forgot to do that. So we're just going to keep looking. Some of these are very environmental-themed, which is great. Some of them are a little on the nose. Let's go with the actual name of the website. We'll see if combining the two keywords gets us... Oh, well, that's... It's relevant. I don't know if I'd... You know what? For today's experiment, let's go with this. Let's go with a retro-style logo, just for fun. Because, like I said, I don't imagine this will end up being the final logo in any case. Now, what sort of type do we want? They're going to show us a series of different types and styles, and we've got to choose which one works best for Website Planet. Well, while I do like this one on the left, the one on the right works a little bit better, even if I'm not big on the box shadow. None of these are actually working for me. Ooh, there we go. That's better. A retro icon with something a little... Ooh, I dislike both. I forgot that was an option. Okay, let's go with that. We're doing a sort of retro icon, and apparently we're going to get some very condensed type. If I sound distracted, it's because the audio foam panels I just put up are falling right off my walls. So that's that's happening. I have got to get some hot glue. Okay, so our first option is this delightfully retro, but slightly noisy sort of text. Not sure that works for us. Let's see. The type is closer to what we have now, but no. No. Better. Definitely better. I will be looking into this. This actually comes very close to our existing logo. With that delightfully retro feel. And that gives it a more sort of elegant... I'm tempted, just for fun. And let's generate some more logos here, just for fun. They only generate a few more at a time by the looks of it. They're getting less and less good. I think the algorithm is starting to feel like it's reaching. I like it, but it's not quite what we need. All right, let's go back up to one of these earlier iterations. Ultimately, I'm going to go with this. Now, to customize it, we're going to need this to be purple, frankly. Oh, there we go. Styles. Folder. Thin. I think the boulder was better. Texture, masculine. Handwritten, classy. Delicate, rounded, retro, trendy. Taller. Let's try taller. Well, this is sort of condensed text. This is a bit too condensed for my taste. At small sizes, it'll be nearly impossible to read. Let's go back to boulder. And I would personally tweak that type a lot. But this is... we're dealing with an algorithm here. I prefer this. Color. We're going with the purple. No, that did not give me the purple I wanted. Purple, please. It's okay, that's a little dark. We want something... well... bluish purple. Purplish blue, maybe? That's too bright. That's too bright. Let's go back to... that is as close as we're going to get to the original color. Frankly, they're not giving me the option to choose specific hex values, and I don't know that I'm a fan of that. Color layout. Oh, you can change which colors are applied. That's nice. It gives you a few options to work with within your chosen color scheme. Let's go back to main. And let's go back to type, because I feel like the type changed on me there. Back to styles. I feel like styles loads very slowly. Let's go with that. There we go. Now we go to layout. Now, as you can see, we have a few different layout options. There's not a lot of room in that header up here, in the header and slash navigation. So we're going to stick with the good old website on top of planet option. And now we can change the icon size. Yes, to better fit with the text. I like that. One thing I'm noticing is that this interface is not very responsive. Now, I'm not downloading or uploading anything, so... oh, there we go. You have to click and drag. The plus and minus icons don't actually seem to do anything, which is a bit unintuitive, if I'm perfectly honest. And yes. Yes, I believe I'm going to save this particular website planet logo. Now, obviously, you have all kinds of options. You can create business cards based on your logo, design social posts, Instagram, order branded merchandise. Doesn't look bad on a shirt, if I'm honest. As logos go, this could certainly be better, but I think with the algorithm and the tools we've been given, this is probably our best option for the moment. So let's click on finish. And through the magic of Hollywood, we're back. If you want to access your logo once you've paid for it, or once you've paid for a subscription, you go up here to My Account, Purchased Brand, and then you will see here where they try to upsell you on about 1,000 other services. That may be a slight exaggeration, but anyway. The only thing you really need to do is go to this link here, download. It will show you every logo version that you've actually purchased. Just go ahead and click download again. Another one of my acoustic panels just fell. I'm going to use nails, I swear to God. And then you get a zip file with some PNGs and JPEGs. Let's see, white logo, dark background, useful. White logo, transparent background. Well, you can't see it. Let's see. Dark logo, transparent background. Excellent. They give you some transparency options to work with. And there it is in color on a white background. And that's it. That's Tailor Brands. So, how do I feel about Tailor Brands? Well, it's mostly usable. Mostly dependable, I think. A few little niggles here and there with the UI. They do a fair bit of upselling, which, you know, a bit aggressive. But otherwise, a fairly serviceable service with some decent features, a couple of interesting standout features. Go check out the full written review for all the details on that. And I hope this was useful and informative. See y'all around.